all those kind of things. So to me, one of the most important things you have in church, you have a service, you have fellowship, and you have Bible study. Right now, we have Reverend Tinsley is leading a Wednesday class, which is a survey of the Bible. Really urge everybody to take part in that. It's via Zoom. But we've also had in the past, in addition to the Sunday morning, we've had pastors done things on Wednesdays. Carolyn Peters used to do something on Wednesday morning. So it's really important to study the Bible because it's challenging for us. So right now we just finished the study of the book of Romans. And the question is, there's two questions in the survey. One is, when would you like to do an adult class? And there are various options, particularly whether we do it again live next door before the service, whether we do it by Zoom before the service or after the service or some other time. So we really want to hear what people want. It's really for your benefit to do this. So that's one of the questions. The other question is, what would you like to study? And there's a list of things, various parts of the Bible or other approaches. Some people might want to study the Presbyterian Confessions or Book of Order or something like that. So I hope everybody will look at the survey and fill it out, put it in, or talk to Christian Ed Department or myself about what you would like to do with studying the Bible. And we've also had Spanish Bible study as well. So please do that and think about it, because that's really part of our walk, is how we study and learn from the Bible. Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Thank you, brother. College Hill communicates regularly through the One Call Facebook, and our website is listed as www.collegehillcommunitychurch.org. Monthly through our electronic newsletter. We also have Prayer Warriors, our electronic prayer chain. We also have a list of special prayer. And we have special prayer for Brenda Brown, Gloria Gates, Michael Love, Jack Givens, Ishmael Jimenez, Bruce and Betty Johnson, Shante Johnson, Kevin Lewis, Monzon family, Martha Savadra Nelson, Nelson Stone, Jose, and Dylan Vidal. And if there are any other announcements at this time, you may present them. All right, we do have a special announcement from our pastor, Tinsley.
Good morning, College Hill. Where is Deacon Lake? Is he outside in the... Okay, well, I'm going to invite you to something anyway. Deacon Lakes is representing you, of course, as a volunteer chaplain for the National Church Residences at Hoover Place, which is way out at the far end of Hoover. And on Tuesday at 3:00, he's going to be hosting a meet and greet for all of the residents whom you have already, or you're sharing him with them. But he's also taking a truckload. Here he is now. He's also taking a truckload of supplies, household supplies, out to people there in need. And so I want to invite you. I get to do that because I'm the regional chaplain. I want to invite you to come to the meet and greet. And what time is it? 3 o'clock? 3 o'clock on Tuesday, the 9th of April. And so it's going to be a joyous time. I think it'll be wonderful if other people from the church can come. And you know, the other thing too is if you come and you see what he's doing, I got some other buildings where you could serve in the same capacity. So I want to commend him. Thank you for sharing him, because I know he's busy here. But I want to commend him for his outreach to the community of whence he comes, and to be a part of that particular outreach of love to people in this community. Can I get an amen? Amen. Also wanted to let you know, we have finished our Lenten studies, and I'd like us to, on Wednesday, to start back with this book, chapter 5. So if you don't have it, see the other Deacon Lakes, and she will make sure that you have that the text, and we will start with it. We're not going to do the whole thing. There's a lot there, and I hope it's something that will be of interest to you. It will be informative to you, and it will be encouraging to you. So we'll start with, we'll get back and start with chapter 5. This is the day that the Lord has made, and we are, amen, amen.
Join in the call to worship. Thanks to the God of mercy, we no longer look for Jesus among the dead. From the waters of death, God has raised us with Christ. Okay, we're going to have a hymn. The singers can come forth.
Good morning. of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. Thus might I hide my blushing face, how this dear cross appears. Dissolve my heart in thankfulness, and melt mine eyes and tears. At the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the days. Last verse. But drops of tears can ne'er repay the debt of love I owe. Here, Lord, I give myself away. 'Tis all that I can do. At the cross, where I first saw the light, and the burdens of my heart rolled away. It was there by faith I received my sight, and now I am happy all the day. At the cross,
forgiven.
Father,
Multicultural Church, College Hill, offers a special greeting to all who join in this worship and praise of God. Each of you has a special place in this community of faith.
Good morning. Como iglesia multicultural, College Hill ofrece una bienvenida especial a todos los que comparten con nosotros este servicio de alabanza. Cada persona tiene un puesto especial en esta comunidad de fe.
We welcome diversity in our worship, in our ministry, and in all the world. We hope you find something in our prayers and praise, in our music of ministry that makes you feel a part of our family, and most of all, of God's family. All are welcome here.
Esta iglesia acoge la diversidad en nuestra adoración, en nuestro ministerio y en todo el mundo. Esperamos que encuentre algo en nuestras oraciones y alabanzas, en nuestra música o ministerio, que los haga sentir parte de nuestra familia y sobre todo de la familia de Dios. Todos sean bienvenidos y bienvenidas.
We especially invite those who are worshiping with us for the first time today, or who are back with us after a long time away, to share their names with us so we can welcome you.
En manera especial, ofrecemos la oportunidad a los que estén presentes hoy con nosotros por primera vez, o los que antes han sido parte de esa iglesia, pero han estado lejos de nosotros por mucho tiempo, a introducirse con su nombre.
This time, we ask worshipers who have written out prayer requests on the sheets in your pews to hand those to the ushers who will be coming down the center aisle right now to collect those prayer requests.
Si usted ha preparado una oración escrita en los papeles en su banco, en este momento las mujeres van a venir para recogerlas.
And while they do that, we ask everyone to stand now in body or in spirit and share the peace of Christ by saying to each other, "The peace of Christ be with you."
Y al mismo tiempo, invitamos a todos a levantarse y a compartir la paz de Cristo, que en español decimos, "La paz de Cristo esté contigo."
Peace of Christ be with you. La paz de Cristo esté con ustedes. We do have some visitors in our midst that are here with us. And raise your hand if you'd like to be recognized. I know there's a grandmother would love to recognize some family.
Okay. I thought she said she would. Okay. Well, good morning. My name is Marcus Lambright. I am a child of this church. I grew up here many years ago, and I'm very glad to be back here to welcome back. I'm here also with my sister Alexis, my wife Kelsey, and my daughter Celeste. And I'm just very glad to worship with you all today. We're coming from New Jersey and New York.
Are there any other visitors or special friends that we'd...
My name is Omenje Chanceline. I've been worshiping here for some weeks now. Thank you, everyone.
And her two sons. It's a pleasure to have you. Thank you. Anyone else? Very good.
Good morning, College Hill. Holy and gracious God, may your spirit give us a spirit of wisdom and revelation so that with the eyes of our hearts enlightened, we may know the hope to which Christ has called us, the riches of glorious inheritance among us, and the greatness of his power for those who believe. Amen.
Good morning, College Show. Today's scripture will be John chapter 20, verses 19 through 31. When it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors were locked where the disciples were, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be within you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." But Thomas, who was called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails on his hands, and put my finger in the mark of the nails, and my hand in his side, I will not believe." A week later, his disciples were again in the house, and Thomas was with them. Although the doors were shut, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands. Reach out your hand and put it in my side. Do not doubt, but believe." Thomas answered him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have come to believe." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book. But these are written so that you may continue to believe that Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God, and that through believing you may have life in his name. This is the scripture of the Lord.
Question for you this morning. When was the last time the Presbytery of Miami Valley met here at College Hill pre-pandemic? When was the last time? 5 years ago. Pardon me? You know that based on the demographics, when I went into that facility, or those facilities. And what I said to him was, first and foremost, besides the fact that the vast, vast, vast majority of the young people in those facilities are identical ethnicity and gender, besides that, First and foremost, I ask him, who should I be scared of? And what should I be scared of? Because I know who is with me because the one that calls me to this work sustains me in the process. So what do I have to be scared of? What do I have to fear? And we talked about fear. We talked about this last week in the Bible study, but we're dealing with that today in this text. Because, as we talked about women last week, the women went to the tomb. The women didn't know that the stone was going to be rolled away. They were worried about how we're going to get in there and do what we're supposed to do. But the men were scared. They had reason to be scared. They had seen what had happened to Jesus. They had killed Jesus, and despite the things that Jesus told them, they're human. Just like the man had asked me if I was scared. You're human. We are fearful at times. That's just human nature. Anybody in here ever been scared? I guess I'm going to see all the hands now. Jesus' disciples, they heard when the women said that this Jesus is back. They were in a room by themselves. They had the door locked, the scripture tells us. The door was locked. And then the scripture also tells us that they were concerned about the Jews. Well, they were Jews too. Now, this text has been used. Well, the Johnine text has been used for anti-Semitic sentiment over the generations. But the idea is the Jews they were concerned about were the same ones that were persecuting Jesus throughout the text during Jesus' ministry. Jesus was a thorn in their side. Jesus was rocking the boat. So they were concerned about the Sadducees, the Pharisees, the chief priests, the scribes, the folks that were going to lose their power because of Jesus, the folks that were responsible for taking Jesus out. So they were concerned about these people coming to see about them too. So they had the door locked. They were in fear. Jesus appears anyway. This locked door doesn't keep Jesus out. The text tells us that Jesus comes in. But think about this. We always find things to be scared of. These folk may be scared too, because remember when Jesus was in need, they turned their backs and ran in fear. They might be concerned that Jesus is going to come and confront them and say, you didn't take care of business when it was time. So they had a lot of things to be scared about. Have you ever been scared when Jesus comes upon you in your prayer and says, it's okay, peace be with you? Can you imagine how these disciples may have felt? We got the door locked, and this Jesus shows up anyway? You would think they would believe at that point. They would say, my Lord and my God, at that point in time. And Jesus says, it's okay. I'm going to forgive you despite the fact that you denied me, in Peter's case, three times. Despite the fact that you ran and you hid, had to send the women down there to check out the tomb. You all came afterwards. Have you ever been in a position when you felt that fear has gone aside when your encounter with Jesus allows you to shout in joy? My Lord and my God, look what you have done for me today. You've set aside all of these problems and issues that I have in my life. But then even as you say that, you may run across people that say, well, I don't never had that happen. I don't see this Jesus in my life. I don't see the evidence of this peace and this courage. What do you tell them, folks? What do you tell them when you run across Thomas? And Thomas says, No, I can't get to that. Have you ever seen a Thomas before? Have you ever run across somebody? And like I said last week, if we had the time, if we took the time, each and every one of you, considering the fact that you are human beings and you have lived on this planet and you have lived with fear, you have lived with joy, you have lived with happiness, you have lived with sadness, but you can provide a testimony of evidence that indeed you have encountered that Jesus and you have put your hand in his hand and in his side and you have shouted with joy, my Lord and my God. So when we go up and down these streets and when we go to our jobs and when we're on the freeway, if we are scared, if we are fearful, turn to God. Say, walk with me, Jesus. Because God is always. Remember the song, Jesus on the Main Line? But we don't have lines anymore, but and Jesus is on the cyberspace too. And God doesn't get weary. God is always there. See, this is what we know and we trust. This is a message that we take out from this place when we shout every day. Each morning, we should be able to say, by the fact that we woke up, my Lord and my God, thank you, Jesus, for another day. And those same young people that I dealt with, I would say, take 10 or 15 minutes every morning and thank God that you woke up. Because that population, a whole lot of people, don't make it to 20 years old. And the fact that they wake up each morning, It's not really rocket science. See, we can tell Thomas that we can testify to the fact that Jesus has walked with us every step of the way, whether we're 15 or 50, 65 or 80, or older. Jesus has blessed us in so many ways. If we were to testify, we'd be here all evening talking about all the good things that God has done for us. But there are those out there that are familiar with, acquainted with, have embraced the concept of fear. That same fear that allows them to be locked behind the closed doors. And oftentimes, they really don't know what the source of that fear is, because fear is a whole lot easier than stepping up and stepping out and holding your head high and paying attention to what the scripture has told us. The song says, what a friend we have in Jesus. Anybody heard that song before? Mm-hmm. That's that same Jesus that endured on our behalf. Because God loved us so much, that by itself is worth a my Lord and my God. Thank you for walking with me today. Thank you for being my friend. Sometimes I wake up and say my Lord and my God, and then I won't sing in front of my wife because she'll leave if I do. She said, now don't sing in church. Definitely don't sing a solo. If you sing, do a duet so that somebody can drown you out. Get Brother Jones to stand next to you and drown you out. But we stood up here last week. If you can sing, if you can talk, you can sing. And sing to the glory of the Lord. My Lord and my God, thank you for your goodness and your grace. Thank you for waking me up one more time because you didn't have to. Thank you for walking with me every step of the way, because sometimes it's a crooked path. Sometimes it's great hills that we have to climb up. But God is with us. God has his hand on our shoulder in the name of Jesus Christ wherever we go. God is with us. The Bible tells us so. The first song that I learned in Sunday school many, many years ago was Jesus Loves Me, This I Know, For the Bible Tells Me So. My Lord and my God. You've gone through some difficulties in the church. Obviously, individuals, we've had our issues. But you're going through difficulties in the church. I've been through that before. One time, there was a church where some folks left. Sound familiar? And some of the folk, they weren't as nice as some of the folk here. They sent somebody to threaten the youth director. And I happened to be the youth director at the time. And they said, if you don't leave here, I'm going to blow your brains out. And I have to tell you, obviously that didn't happen. But I found out later that that individual did do that to somebody. Now, if I had been fearful, and I figured that I was in this by myself, because we're never alone. If I was in that by myself, I would have quit at that time. I did leave the church for a while, because there were folks, this was 50 years ago, and they wanted me to go to seminary. And I said, if this is the way people act, get it? Here's the word, people. If this is the way people act, then I don't want to have anything to do with that. But God called anyway. It took a while. But when I came back, I was introduced to a pastor at that same church who sat down in a session meeting, and people were moaning and groaning, well, we don't have enough money to pay these bills. We don't know if Presbytery is going to come in and take us over. They look for all kinds of things to be scared about. We do well at that. We do well at trying to find things to worry about. And he said, set that aside. Trust in the Lord, and the Lord will provide. He took that church from four members and turned it into one that's nationally known now. And it's not a church that's it's in the hood, but the hood disappeared. It got gentrified. So now they can have Presbytery meetings there. People can show up because they're not scared to go to the Presbytery meeting. But the point is, we as Easter people, we've been through it. We have seen what has happened to Jesus on our behalf. And Jesus has assured us, peace be with you. You're forgiven for all the things that you may have done, that we have done. And my Lord and my God, you indeed are the one that has been sent to save us, even from ourselves, and particularly our fears. Set them aside. Go out of here with joy, with smiles on your face, and let people know that indeed we are people for Christ. We are Easter people. And we ain't going nowhere. Amen. God bless you, church. And amen. And we are going to sing. See, oftentimes when we are fearful, Our eyes are indeed closed. We don't know which way to turn. So when we say, my Lord and my God, we can also say, open my eyes that I may see glimpses of truth thou hast for me. Place in my hands, oh, that wonderful key that shall unclasp and set us free from fear, from apprehension, from anger, from all the isms, from all the phobias, from all those things that separate us from the love of Jesus Christ. Silently now, we're waiting for Jesus, ready, our God, your will to see. So Lord God, my Lord and my God, open our eyes and illumine us, Spirit divine. Amen.
Amen. Let us rise and sing as our choral responds this, another stalwart of this time and of this message and of this season that should be our testimony in the world.
Glimpses of truth thou hast for me. Place in my hands the wonderful key that shall unclasp and set me free. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my eyes, illumine me. Savior divine, open my ears that I may hear voices of truth thou sendest clear. And while the wave notes fall on my ear, everything false will disappear. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my ears, illumine me. Spirit divine, open my mouth and let me bear gladly the warm truth everywhere. Open my heart and let me prepare love with thy children thus to share. Silently now I wait for thee. Ready, my God, thy will to see. Open my heart, illumine me. Spirit divine.
Amen, amen.
Let us join together as we affirm our faith in that wonderful God that walks with us as we read the Nicene Creed as it's before you on the screen. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshiped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Amen. This is a time that we take a deep breath and we let go of all of those things that keep us down, including fear. And we go before our God joyfully and joyously. First and foremost, thanking God for all that God has done for each and every one of us, for the things that God has done for this particular church, the things that God has done for this community and this world. And sometimes we also go to God, as Jesus tells us, to bring things to him in prayer. So we bring our petitions, our concerns, our fears, our apprehensions, and we ask for God's grace and God's mercy. So now is the time, if you like to verbalize those, feel free to do that. Elder Jones has a microphone. Are there those who wish to lift up for special prayer?
Good morning, College Hill. I'm Marlia Gaskins, and I just want everyone to know that God is with us every day, yes. All the time.
Yes.
Yesterday, I went to Columbus to visit my aunt. She's 98 years old. This month, the whole family was there. It was the most beautiful thing in the world, and she was happy as she could be. They moved her into a beautiful place so she wouldn't be by herself. She's fighting it a little bit, so I asked God to give her some grace, and please help her to understand that being there is the place she needs to be, and the family will be there with her. Thank you, God.
Amen.
98 Amen. Years old. Amen.
I'd like to pray for those who are having surgery. Kathy Lakes, keep her lifted in prayers. Yes.
Amen.
Good morning, family.
Good morning.
I'm having a problem with my neck. I can't turn anything. I had to turn my whole body, and I done did everything for it. So I went to the doctor, and so she did some x-rays. I don't know what's going on, but when I do turn it, I feel popping in my neck. You know, I don't know. So just pray that she can fix it or it'll fix itself. God come down and touch it and fix it. I am so serious, but I am in so much pain. But that did not stop me from coming. Thank you.
I'm a witness, my sister. That pain can go away.
Deacons and elders, whether active or inactive,
what we sense here is a need to lay our hands on this young lady.
Put your hands in this posture to send the Spirit this way.
gracious God, we sometimes don't know. Sometimes we don't know which way to turn. Sometimes we find ourselves clueless. But God, we know and we trust that indeed, even in times of sickness and even in times of suffering and pain, you are the one that we can call upon no matter what the situation. You are the doctor who has never lost a patient. You are the counselor that has all the answers. So we come to you this morning because your child is hurting this morning. And we know and we trust that you have encouraged and empowered her medical providers to find an answer. So this morning, Lord, we pray for comfort. We pray for peace. We pray for your presence in her life, your child, your sweet child. Walk with her today, Lord. And each and every one of us as we seek to support her in all of our endeavors, for we pray these things in the powerful name of Jesus. Amen. Join me, folks. I'm so glad Jesus lifted me.
So his mom took him to the hospital, but he was in the bathroom. He said, I got to go to church to accolade. I said, baby, you're going to be okay. You go to the hospital, you got to accolade next week.
Amen.
So pray for my baby, please.
Amen. Amen.
I know we had another prayer request. James?
So I mentioned him once saying, I great thanks to Jesus. God in heaven. Thank you, Jesus.
All right. Pray for James's mom, Irma Webb.
Good morning. I'd like to make a prayer request. Crystal Lewis, my daughter-in-law, her brother, Kevin, is very ill right now. And so I'd like to keep him very much in prayer. He also won, and this is a celebration for him, He got an award for the state of Indiana for being a referee for athletes. So he did get that award this last week. So we're very happy and congratulate him on that.
And perhaps we can all pray for Purdue, who is in the final.
Prayers for my neighbor, Bozy Melanor. He passed, so I'm asking prayers for his family.
I'm asking prayers and celebrations. Glad to see the Lambright family. They are such a treasure to College Hill Church. The young man is a pastor, and we like to say that's a product of College Hill Church and what the kids can do when you put your mind to it, and we lead them to the cross. And safe traveling as you part from here. God bless you all, and so excited to see you.
Clear skies also for the eclipse tomorrow.
I want to say prayers for a young man named Jeremiah. I believe he's like 19 years old. My friends and I were out a couple of weeks ago having dinner, and we ran into him, and I remember when we came across him, he smelled really bad, and you know, some of my friends' natural response was to just like walk away and ignore him, but one of my friends actually went over and spoke to him and found out, you know, he's 19 years old, and he had been sleeping in an abandoned building for about 2.5 weeks because his foster mother put him out. And, you know, I know that 19 years old is a legal adult, but I know from experience, and I'm sure all the parents know, when you're 19, you're not really an adult yet. And so he's just been kind of out on his own. So one of my friends actually took him in and is helping him now. So they're trying to, you know, get him a job and get him, I think, into like Job Corps or someplace to, you know, just to help him get his life on track, because they went and spoke to his foster mother, and she kind of just wants nothing to do with him. So just pray for him and pray for my friend that's helping him.
For all youth that are struggling with the challenges of today's world. Amen? Amen.
I want to make a prayer for my nephew, David. He's going through something, I don't know, but I'll hand it to God. And I want the church to pray for him. Thank you.
Amen. For David.
I want to ask prayers for my nephew. He came to visit me. He lives in Washington, D.C., and he's traveling this morning, going back home, and he came and took me to lunch and spent some time with me yesterday. So Amen. Traveling mercies for him.
All right. Amen. Family connections, family connections. Amen.
Just a continuing prayer for peace in the world. Israel and Gaza, all those people dying there. And today's Daily News has a thing about Rwanda. You remember the genocide there? It actually talks about the Democratic Republic of Congo, which is doing so much worse than Rwanda is doing. And people are trying to forgive each other. Then says what happened is people used fear to cause people to kill each other, and that's something that seems to be happening in other places too. So when you talk about fear, less fear means less of that. So just pray for people of goodwill to enforce their goodwill on the rest of the world, which isn't doing that.
Amen. Amen.
Someone is asking for prayers for their mental health, prayers for family and strength to make it through, get over with God's help. Prayer for someone's brother-in-law who's battling throat cancer, cousin Carter family who are mourning the loss of their mother. Someone asked prayers for their son, Prince, as he continues to heal. heart surgery of Carol Scribner, Kathy's sister. And last but not least, a happy 26th birthday to Salma Leticia Jones Pacheco. I'm fine. Wow, what a blessing. Amen. Amen. Somebody mentioned Indiana. Prayers for Indiana. I can talk about it. I was born in Indiana. And it always needs prayers. So let us, once again, just take a moment. Say together, my Lord and my God. Take a deep breath and let go of all the mess, of all the pains and suffering that we deal with, the road rage, dealing with all the isms and the phobias. Let's let go and let God take control of each and every one of our lives, now and always. So let us once again close our eyes and bow our heads and go to our God. Let us bow before that throne of grace as we pray for God's goodness and God's mercy. Eternal God, give you thanks this morning for the splendor and the wonder of your creation. Praise you for your spirit within all things uniquely, mysteriously, in Jesus of Nazareth, one with you. For the light he brought, the love he shared, the hospitality he showed. God, we adore your name and your holy and your divine nature. You are with us always, and you are gracious and compassionate to us. You know us by name and by your transformation of us through baptism, nurture, and continued care. We enjoy your undeserved favor. You touch our lives, oh God, blessing us and surrounding us with your love and your mercy. But sometimes, oh God, we're slow to respond. We who are so very fortunate, blessed, and sustained by your grace, sometimes forget that you have called us as followers of Christ Jesus to reach out beyond our bases of affluence, of comfort, and contentment. We know there are hungry folks out there, oh God. There are needy people in our midst. There are brothers and sisters all about us who seek shelter from the sometimes violent storms of life. There are those living in loneliness, those suffering from depression or mental illness. We remember those who are incarcerated, justly or unjustly. Those who are sick and shut in. Those who are dying. Those who are bereaved. We lift up all the names of those that we have remembered this morning. And even those only known to you, we ask your tender touch and your blessing every step of the way in their lives and our own lives. God of power, God of all power, Jesus, may we and all people find strength for this journey we call life. Grant us this day healing and the completion which this world cannot give. Focus our hearts, our minds, and our souls upon you in everything we do. So God, on this beautiful April morning, the second Sunday of Easter, that you have made and blessed, we pray for justice, for equity and equality, for the cessation of violence in places even right outside these very doors that are torn apart by violence and conflict. And God, send us boldly and fearlessly out in Jesus' name to rescue the lost, to heal the injured, and to feed the hungry and even one another with knowledge and understanding, tolerance and compassion, with respect and love. Strengthen us in all that we can do to make a difference. May we see in Jesus, the Lamb of God, and hear your declaration of forgiveness, your word of love made once for eternity. Draw us even closer into union with your Spirit. And may we be one with you, embraced at peace with love in our hearts. We look forward to the moment when Christ will say to us, "Peace be with you." Almighty God, our Son, our Savior, our Liberator, Christ Jesus, is the light of the world. Grant that your people may shine with the radiance of his glory, that he may be known and worshiped and obeyed to the ends of the earth. The very one who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. For we ask all these prayers, along with the prayer that our Lord Jesus taught his disciples and us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, ever and ever. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and tell him that you love him.
We now offer in gratitude and praise our gifts to God for the life of this church and the world. Returning to God the offering of our lives and the gifts of the earth, those here in the sanctuary may prepare your offering now. Today we will be taking up two offerings, our regular offering in the metal plates carried by the ushers, and then our first fruits offering for hunger in the wicker baskets that follows the metal plates. Please give generously to both offerings. Those worshiping online after the service are welcome to send your offerings by mail directly to College Hill Church, 1547 Philadelphia Drive, Dayton, Ohio, 45406. We will advise you when an electronic donation service becomes available in the future. Scripture reminds us that every generous act of giving is itself a gift from God above. So we now offer ourselves with joy and hope.
Thank you.
The way of our money helps or hurts others matter to you, and so that we ask this money would help your reign to flourish. Amen.
Spirit's been moving in this place today, church. Amen. Not only does the Spirit move and walk with us, our God continues to nourish us and to feed us and to give us the strength and the power to be about the business of love and peace and joy in this community, this world community, not just West Dayton, not just in Ohio, but in this world. God reaches out to us and continues to nourish us in ways beyond our imagination. Amen. God feeds us that we do not have to fear, that we can walk from this place with our heads high and be about the business of love and peace and joy. So God has prepared in Jesus Christ this table before us today. They will come from east and west and north and south to sit at table in the kingdom of God, to be nourished and empowered. This is the Lord's table. He invites all those who trust in him to sit at table in the kingdom of God. Let us pray. And God of all power, ruler of the universe, you are worthy of glory and praise. At your command, all things came to be, the vast expanse of interstellar space, galaxies, suns, the planets in their courses, and this fragile earth, our island home. From the primal elements, you brought forth the human race and blessed us with memory and reason and skill. You made us the rulers of creation, but we turned against you and betrayed your trust. And we turned against one another. Again and again and again, you called us to return. Through prophets and sages, you revealed your righteous law. And in the fullness of time, you sent your only son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law, to open for us the way of freedom and peace. So, Lord God of our fathers, God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, indeed open our eyes to see your hand at work in the world about us. Deliver us from the presumption of coming to this table for solace only and not for strength, for pardon only and not for renewal. Just let the grace of your holy communion make us one body, one spirit in Christ, that we may worthily serve the world in Jesus' name. And so, God, we who have been redeemed by him and make a new people by water and the Spirit. Now bring before you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be the body and blood of Jesus our Lord. Accept these prayers and praises, O God, through Jesus Christ, our great high priest, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit, your church gives honor, glory, and worship from generation to generation. Amen. Friends, according to Luke, when our risen Savior appeared before his disciples, he took bread and he blessed it. And their eyes were open and they recognized him. Indeed, this is the Lord's table. He invites all those who trust in him to partake in this feast, which he has so graciously prepared for each and every one of us. On the night before his arrest, our Lord Jesus took bread, and after giving thanks to God, he broke it. He gave it to his disciples. He said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And after the same manner, he took the cup. He said, "This cup is a new covenant sealed in my blood, shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Every time you drink it, do it in remembrance of me." So friends, as often as you eat this bread, if you drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Amen. Bread of heaven, Jesus' body given for you. Jesus said, "I am the vine, you are the branches. Without me, you can do nothing. This is the blood of Jesus shed for you." Lamb of God, O Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world, have mercy. Amen.
Ahora salgan de aquí en el nombre de Jesucristo, recordando su mandamiento. Amén, amémonos unos a otros, así como Él nos amó.
Now go forth in Jesus' name, remembering his commandment to love one another, just as he has loved us.
My Lord and my God, We go out from this place today with smiles on our faces. We go out from this place with our heads up. We go out from this place reaching out beyond our very selves as we seek to be Easter people for God. There may be things that we're scared of. There may be things that we're fearful of. There may be some interesting situations out there. But God has empowered us. God has fed us. God has given us the strength and the encouragement. Amen. And so now may the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit and the peace and the power of our Lord and our Savior, Jesus the Christ, rest, rule, and abide in each and every one of us today and for every tomorrow. And all of God's people said, amen. So let us stand together as we sing the closing hymn. Every morning, every morning is Easter morning. From here and now on, every day is Redemption Day and Resurrection Day. The past is over and gone. Goodbye, guilt. Goodbye, fear. Good riddance. Hello, Lord. Hello, Son. I am one of the Easter people. My new life has begun. Let us sing together.
Good and strong.
Every morning is Easter morning from now on. Every day is Resurrection Day. The past is over and gone. Goodbye, guilt. Goodbye, fear. Good riddance. Hello, Lord. Hello, Son. I am one of the Easter people. My new life has begun. Every morning is Easter. Seldom gets heard. Get it straight from the Easter people. God's in charge, spread the word. Every morning is Easter morning from now on. Every day is Resurrection Day. The past is over and gone. Yesterday I was bored and lonely, but today look and see. I belong to the Easter people. Life's exciting to me. Every morning is Easter morning from now on. Every day's Resurrection Day. The past is over and gone.
Every morning is Easter morning. Every morning is